Hey everybody, this is Tiffany, and if you see my videos before, you know that I am a speech language pathologist and a person who stutters, and this is my roommate, Leticia.
Peace and love.
She's been in a couple of my videos before, and she's great. What we're going to be talking about today is, there are a bunch of phenomenon that, affect, people who stutter's fluency. So fluency is like basically like the lack of stuttering. So there are some techniques that make us more fluent. They're called fluency enhancing conditions. And the most effective across the board, phenomenon is this thing called choral speech, and it's basically where someone who stutters can read or talk along with someone else saying the same thing as them, and they don't stutter. Like, it's like 100% fluent in most people, and it works for most, like almost 100% of people. It's crazy. So I'm going to show you guys that. So I'm going to start by reading and not doing anything to control my stutter. So it's going to be very, very severe. And then my roommate and I will read together and you'll see just how incredible the difference is. Okay. All right. All right. So I'm going to read to you guys about the basal ganglia and psychiatric disorders in my neuroscience textbook. Okay. So basal ganglia. Psychiatric. Disorders. The BG base movement disorders are also known to have psychiatric concomitants. Okay, I'm gonna stop. That was one sentence. It's quite rough. So now we're gonna read together a different sentence, because I don't want to get into a different technique.
I think I can read.
I hope you can read.
I don't know about that.
We're gonna read it together, and you'll see.
Try.
Okay, so we can read case studies for problem solving.
Oh.
So it's a different section, so that is not the same thing.
How about we read this one first, what you said?
Well, I don't want to read the same one, because there's another fluency enhancing phenomenon called adaptation, to where you can read the same thing over and over and over, and the more you read, the more fluent you get. So I don't want to mess with that. I just want to read something different. Okay, so we're going to read up here. So we'll start here, and we'll read together, okay?
A 60-year-old
woman suddenly developed partial paralysis weakness in her left leg while sitting in the same posture for sewing. Within 24 hours, the paralytic attack was replaced by involuntary movements in her leg and arm. She was admitted to the hospital. On testing, she exhibited the following signs. She clearly stopped reading with me.
Oh, I know.
But that was really cool, right? Because it was so clear in that little clip just now that when she was reading, when she wasn't. Because every time I didn't hear her reading with me, it made me stutter so much.
So what is this, like an auditory trick? Like, can you explain that?
Yes.
Partner a group reading and why it enhances fluency or whatever.
Yeah. So the reason that choral speech works, essentially, is that you are changing the way that you're hearing your speech. So there is this thing in our brain called sensory motor integration. It's like the neuroscience term. You don't need to know that. But the sensory input is kind of like what you hear and what you feel. Hearing is the important thing here. And so anything that you do that changes the way you hear yourself speak changes the motor output. So it changes the actual like movements of your speech if you stutter. It affects people who don't stutter in some ways, like different manipulations can affect you, can affect your sensory motor integration. But like people who stutter especially, we have a problem with sensory motor integration, we think. So anything that changes motor integration, you don't really need to know it. It's just an interesting thing. If you're interested in learning more about it, it's kind of what it is. So if you change what you're hearing, change how you hear your speech, then you change the way you're speaking.
I have a question. So you can talk fluently, but reading fluently is different. Why do you think there's a difference?
Okay, so that is a different question. So the only reason I talk more fluently than I read is because I do a lot to my spontaneous speech to control my stutter and to hide my stutter.
Like what?
So one thing that I do, which I don't really necessarily advocate or like doing, is that I change the way my voice sounds. So I change the pitch of my voice, the intonation, my accent sometimes. And anytime I do that, it changes the way I hear my speech. And it makes me more fluent, just like this choral speech thing. It changes the way I hear my speech, so it makes me stutter less. The catch is that it doesn't work all the time. So once my brain gets used to hearing a different voice, it stops working. So that's the thing.
So pitch and accent.
Mm-hmm.
That's craziness.
Anything. Adding feedback. If you hear music, if you hear white noise, if you hear someone talking with you, anything. Anything that changes the way you hear yourself, then it'll affect your fluency. People who don't stutter sometimes can have this too. It just affects them differently. Sometimes it can make them stutter, which we can do another video on that next time. But that's just one of the things we wanted to tell you guys. I think I'm going to do a series where I talk about these phenomenons that make people who stutter more fluent, because there's a ton of them, and they're all very interesting. So this is the biggest one. This is the one that by far affects us the most and has the most dramatic effect on our fluency, that increases our fluency the most. So that was it for now. Thanks for watching. Subscribe, comment, like, do all that stuff. Watch my other videos, and we'll see you guys next week. Bye.
Bye.